New Hampshire's eastern brook trout are a native fish found throughout the state's many streams, lakes, and rivers. This cold water species thrives in cool, clean, well-oxygenated water. Throughout New Hampshire, there is an effort to maintain this habitat and fishery.
New Hampshire, when you look back at time, there's actually a law in the books in the mid-1800s which suggested that folks should work very hard to straighten the streams and remove logs, remove rocks from stream channels and rivers, to straighten them and make them easier to drive logs or to farm on the edges of the floodplain.
We'll just assembly line it.
If you have more pool habitat and if you have more cover habitat, all this complexity makes it hard to fish in, but the fish do very well in it. Just the volume of the logs in the stream, does that seem to be related to how many trout or the overall biomass and population of the trout? And the short answer is yes. The more wood, the more trout.
At Emerson Brook, located in the Nash Stream Forest, a long-term study has been underway.
We've been doing research in Emerson Brook since 2009. We've been doing that research almost every year since then. And what we've learned is this, like a lot of small streams in a watershed, these are really the spawning factories for brook trout.
The research has shown that wood in the streams helps this process.
So we mimicked natural processes of wood falling naturally into streams, and we did it with chainsaws in our arms and our backs and got them in here. And what we're finding already is just 2 years later, there's just as many trout here in this section as there are in our sections that we restored 10 years ago using the same techniques.
Methods learned not only at Emerson Brook, but from across the country are now being applied throughout New Hampshire. The idea is to get large wood securely into streams to create habitat.
With a large wood loading, first and foremost, there's the protocol that we try to follow.
U.S. Forest Service has a general prescription for every linear mile of stream channel. They'd like to see, on average, 170 to 230 pieces of large wood.
So if you break that down, like fudge the numbers a little bit, you want to call it 100 feet of river requires roughly 4 pieces of large wood.
Preserving the upper watershed is really important for preserving the water quality lower in the watershed. And so the two really are linked. You can think about the upper watershed as really a filter, a water filter for the water that's headed eventually for the lake.
At a stream in Alton, New Hampshire, a wood in stream project is in its early stages.
We learned about the wood in stream program from the Belknap County Conservation District for this property, the Cotton Herd property. It's a method of making riffles and pools, basically, in a stream that provide habitat for eastern brook trout.
When I first heard that, it was a bit of a surprise to me because I've probably been around the logging end of forest involvement a little more than conservation. And it's a big no-no to put wood in a stream under those circumstances. So now we're going to do it deliberately. And as I listened and learned and began to understand why and how good it is, I hope that it spreads and becomes more accepted throughout the entire forest community. Everybody who's involved in the forest should know about this.
You know, I mean, we can dip in right here.
The first step in the process is assessing what needs to be done along the stream and where the wood will come from with minimal impact.
You know, not many streams are genuine first order.
But it looks like it's great spawning substrate in here. I like it.
It is. For the most part, it's sandy, gravelly. You do see a lot of the, you know, the boulders and stuff, but that's not the dominant substrate by any stretch. the material that we use, the wood that we use, is the immediate riparian tree stand. So we're going to be looking at the types of trees, species of trees, and the size of the trees surrounding the stream channel, because we're going to need to know when we go in, what do we have available to use. We take fresh green standing trees and add them to the stream channel. If something's already on its way in, you know, standing deadwood, or it's already down across the stream channel, we don't touch that. One of the biggest components for me that I'm always looking for is, more than anything else, stability of the wood, security of the wood. I want to see, when I come back here a year, 2, 5 years later, I want to see the wood in the position that I'd felled it and put it into the stream the day that we did it. The real test of any large wood installation is the first winter and then spring runoff. If any given wood installation can survive the ice flows or the heavy freshet flows during snow melt, they're going to be pretty well secure in place.
Brook trout are not the only benefactors of wood being placed in streams.
Water moves things. Water moves, you know, you've heard of runoff, runoff into lakes, runoff into streams, runoff of nutrients, you know, nutrient loads that, you know, think nutrients, that's a good thing. Well, nutrients at too big of a load can be a bad thing. It can cause blooms and can cause problems for water quality if it's done in a flush. So this can slow down those nutrients moving through a system.
What we want to do is we want to reduce all those excess nutrients and sediment from going downstream, especially into our lakes. One of the ways we do this is by carefully felling trees and strategically placing them into streams.
Very good.
Natural, healthy streams look messy.
It has been learned that adding wood to streams is not only beneficial to trout, but also for the people that enjoy all that New Hampshire's lakes and streams provide.
I'm Linda Brownson. I'm a forest landowner and district supervisor in the Grafton County Conservation District. And I've learned that putting wood in stream is critically important to our native eastern brook trout and protecting our rivers and lakes through reducing nutrient runoff going downstream. We can restore streams naturally with large wood to improve aquatic habitat and water quality. Trees don't fall in the streams anymore like they did when northern forests were older forests. Providing the ecological benefits of older trees falling in the stream is possible, however, through controlled practices that imitate these natural forces. And you can make a difference in improving stream habitat for the survival of our trout. Contact your county conservation district or your local New Hampshire Fish and Game office to learn how you can get involved. There are financial, educational, and technical resources available to help landowners and communities to restore their streams. Mimicking nature may be the best hope for our native eastern brook trout. Let's work together and make it happen.